Good morning, my dear students. How are you all? I hope everyone is fine at their home. Have you enjoyed your Diwali vacation? Yes, yes. You might have not enjoyed too much like every year. This year you might have enjoyed with a little bit safety. Yes? Yes, safety is very important. And I hope you have enjoyed your Diwali vacation. So now let us begin with our study. Let's start our study. Yes or no? It's time to start our study. So, my dear kids, do you remember what is this? Yes, these are the rocks. These are the rocks which we have learned in the previous lesson. Do you remember? Yes, yes or no? So we have learned this rocks in the previous lesson. We have learned how it is formed. But have you ever imagined if these rocks are break into the tiny pieces? Tiny means what? Very small pieces. If these rocks are divided or breaks into the very small pieces, then what it is formed? Can you imagine? Yes, it forms soil. Yes, can you see this? This is the soil. So today's chapter is that we are going to discuss about the lesson number 6 from the textbook, that is soil erosion and its conversation. Soil erosion and its conservation. Okay, so I have told you that if the rocks are breaks into the small pieces, it is converted into the small rocks, that is called as a soil. But how it is converted, how the big rock is converted or divided into the small tiny rocks? Can you just tell me? See, today first we will learn the formation. First we will learn how the soil is formed. Formation of soil. We are going to discuss first how the soil is formed. Now if you will see, this is a rock, big rock. Okay. If this rock is converted or if this rock is break into the tiny particles, how it is converted? Because of the continuous or the repeated heating, cooling and drying. Means what happens? This heating is taken place by the sun, by the continuous repeated heating of sun, by the cooling and by drying. Now cooling is taken place by the rain. Now see, due to the heat, means due to the sun heat, you can see the temperature during the summer, it is very hot. Am I right? The temperature is very high. Due to that, the rock gets a crack. But this does not happen in a year or in a month. It takes number of years. Due to the heat of the sun, due to that temperature, the rocks are break into the tiny particles. How? See, it gets first crack, and after getting the crack, after that we get during rainy season. What happens? The raindrops, the water droplets, during the rainy season, what happens? The water droplets are gone into this crack. Okay? During rainy season, these water droplets are collected in this crack. Are you getting? After collecting, after rainy season, which season is there? Winter season. During winter season, the water droplets are cooled, means the liquid particles, that is the liquid. Water is in which state? Yes, it is in a liquid state. It gets converted into the solid states. Means the water droplets are converted into the ice, that is in the solid state. It takes some space. Now these water droplets will get some space. Are you getting? So it helps to break the rock. It helps to break the rock. Like this, the continuous process, and this process takes place in number of year. It can take now 100 year, 1000 year. It depends on the rock, how much big the rock it is. Because of this continuous process, this process is called as a weathering. This process is called as a weathering. This is continuous process of heating, cooling and drying by the sun, wind and the rain causes the rocks to break down into the small particle, to break down the rocks into the very small particles. That is how the soil is formed. What it is formed? The soil is formed. Are you getting? How are you getting? How the soil is formed? The continuous or the repeated heating, cooling and drying by sun, wind and the rain causes the rocks to break down into the very small particles, and that whole process, this whole process is called as a weathering, and that is how the soil is formed. Now if you will see the soil, now see, for this you can do one activity. The next is activity, you can do it. What is the activity? You have to take a glass. Are you getting? And in that glass, you can take some mud, handful of a mud, and you have to pour in the glass. The glass should be of glass. Are you getting? It should be poured into the glass, and after pouring the mud or the soil in the glass, you have to pour some water. First you have to take a sand, or you can take a soil. Which is outside of your home, you can take a soil. Then you have to add some water, little water. The third step is you have to stir it. You have to stir the soil. Suppose this is a soil, whatever you will take the soil, you will take some water in it. You have to stir it, and after stirring, you will keep that glass for 5 to 10 minutes away. Let it bit get settled down. Let that all the mud or all the soil get settled down. After settling, you can see the number of layers. You can see the different layers on the glass. You can see the first layer, which is consists of tiny rocks. The first layer you will see the downside. At the bottom, the first layer you will see the tiny rocks. That is called as a gravel. Little bit rocks particle. And above this layer, you can see little bit mud. So that is sand. And above this layer, means little bit in this sand, you can see the number of very minute rocks. And above that, you can see the one more layer of the soil, which is consist of only clay. Clay means the rocks which is there, it is converted totally into the powder form. The rocks which is converted into powder form, that is called as a clay. Then above the clay, you can see the water. And above this, you can see the humus. Which is very important. So this layer of the soil, this is called as a composition of soil. Now, can you just tell me whether the soil is very important. What is the use of the soil? Whether it is very important? Yes, soil is very important. Because of the soil, we can grow the plants. We can grow the plant. And it is this, the soil is formed on the uppermost layer of the earth. This is formed on the uppermost layer of the earth. Now, soil is very important because it helps the plant grow. In the soil, we can get a different types of mineral. We can get a different types of mineral. So the next point is uses of soil. Use of soil. The soil is firstly important to grow the plants. Now, plants are very important. Yes or no? Now, what is the use of the plant that we have learned in the second lesson? That is growing the plants. That is we have learned. So, because of the soil, the plants can grow. Yes or no? So, for the plant, we need the soil. Then, soil helps us to storage of water. Then, for the storage of water, underground water, we can get from the soil. We can get from the soil. So, soil, the second use of the soil is we can get underground water. For example, borewell, the water we get from the underground. So, because of the soil. So, this is the second important use of the soil. Then, the soil provide us mineral. It provide us mineral. Soil is important that we can get a different types of minerals. Are you getting? So we have learned in today's video, I have discussed about how does the soil is formed. Then we have discussed about different types of layers of the soil. So that is called as a composition of the soil, and we have discussed about uses of the soil. So you have to read this lesson till uses of the soil. Draw the diagram for the layer of the soil. You have to draw the composition of the soil which is given in your test book. Are you getting? So before we conclude, there are the two MCQs which are given in your text. We will just solve it. See the first MCQ. Rocks break into the smaller pieces due to rain, wind, or both rain and wind. Yes, answer is C. So tick to the C, everyone. Yes, I hope everyone has done. Second is soil supports the growth of the plant by holding their leaves, stem, or root. What is there underground? Root, stem, or the leaves? Yes, of course, root. The soil holds the root very firmly. Yes or no? So tick to the root. Yes, I hope everyone has done. Today's work will be that you have to read this lesson till uses of the soil and remove the difficult words and write in your science notebook. Thank you.